Hello, I'm Mr. R. Midger, a retired lecturer in metallurgy preaching Christianity and Sikhism. Here we are going to talk about respect and honor. So just to recapture, the greatest respect goes to mother, and the honor then builds up from mother to father, and then to rabbi, and rabbi up to rabbi, they give you moral education, scriptures we call it. Then when the rabbi become corrupt and inefficient, then Christ, the very Son of God, comes to give the very gospel, which is his word. So gospel is not scripture. Although the base of the scripture is gospel, but to understand scripture, you need to have a knowledge of the gospel. That's why Jesus came to explain to these rabbis the basics of the moral laws. And that is what he was doing when he was of the age of 12 at the temple. He was explaining to them the roots of those moral laws. Now, Jesus respected the rabbis. He did not despise them. So the order is that, you know, one who is below you in honor, you should respect him. So Christ Jesus respected the rabbis and told those people who are healed of the physical sicknesses, go and give to your rabbi the proper due. Present him with the present as expected on being healed. So he still sent, although he did the healing, but he still sent them, go and honor your rabbi. So Jesus respected the rabbis, for they were rendering the service, bringing up the children morally sound. So that's why Jesus said, do what the rabbis tell you to do, but don't follow their copy, because they have become hypocrites. And the most important thing in Jesus is that you have to become solitary. So when you become solitary, you don't follow anyone, but follow your inner man, the Christ. So on this net, you know, we have many brethren who are men of spirit and who have started to grasp the ideas and acquire knowledge, and then speaking independently of me or anybody else, their points of views. So they are exercising or using the Holy Spirit to make their videos and speeches. In Jesus, what comes out of your own mouth, that should make sense. And when you approach to that standard, then the Christ in you is the man which is dominating your future or dominating your destiny. Remember the born blind person, he was master of his own destiny. He did not go by what his parents told him or what the rabbis was telling him. He was going independent. Same way Jesus was solitary, and he made the other people solitary. So these rabbis, they were lacking the spirit behind the scripture, which is oral Torah. So they were lacking the knowledge of oral Torah, and that's why Jesus came. The knowledge of oral Torah is represented by the middle candle of the menorah. So when these rabbis, they had the knowledge of the menorah, knowledge of the oral Torah, then all the seven candles of the menorah were at par, same level. But as you know, when Christ Jesus came, they were mostly dead in spirit, especially the people in Jerusalem. They only were sticking to the books, book knowledge. And when Jesus healed that born blind person, and when born blind person told them, "Do you want to become his disciples? Do you want to follow Jesus?" They said, No. We have Moses' Torah for us. We don't want anything else." So they were dead in letters. So Christ Jesus came to give them life, but they rejected him. But they loved darkness. So for coming and giving them the light, he is also called the Lord of the Sabbath. The Sabbath is the middle candle of the menorah. That is the representing God. So Jesus came to represent God. So he was the Lord of the Sabbath. And in his honor, this middle candle of the menorah raised above the other six. But you see, these Messianic Jews, they are keeping all the six, seven candles at par, same level, meaning that Christ Jesus has not come into this world. So they are rejecting Messiah, and they are hypocrites of the first order. So Christ Jesus came to give the light. For light, he is to be honored highly. So we have the respect of the greatest respect of the mother for procreation, for looking after you when you were a child or when you could not look after yourself, feeding you well, so that making your body strong. Same, this planet Earth is our mother, and if we look after it, we produce food which is healthy. When food is healthy, your physical body is healthy too. Same is the part played by the mother, that she gives you healthy food to keep you strong. For this service, she is highly respected. So the Christ Jesus respected John the Baptist, and John the Baptist respected the rabbis who were blind to spirit, and to the men who were simpletons, which he called stones turning into the sons of Abraham. But the clever people, which were the Jerusalem temple priest, he called them brood of vipers. And I have put videos why they were called brood of vipers and how they destroyed Christianity, and they are responsible for the sectarian riots and also the Holocaust, which took place in Germany, in which not a single Jew died, because Jew is a spiritual self. In the next video, I will explain the rest.